Good afternoon, one and all. This is Prajakta Patsukar from the Department of Microbiology, KTGM College, Nasik. So let's see about the staining technique. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the differential staining. Now, what is differential staining? In case of the differential staining, we are making the use of more than one stain. So by using that two type of the stain, we can easily differentiate between two microorganisms. So let's start with the first type of differential staining, that is the Gram staining. Gram stain is developed in 1884 by the Danish physician Christian Gram and is the most widely used method in the bacteriology. Gram staining is the first and usually the only method employed for the identification of bacteria in clinical specimens. So principle of this Gram staining, as you know, in case of the differential staining, we are making the use of two stains. So in case of the Gram staining, crystal violet will be a primary stain and the safranin is the secondary stain or the counter stain. In addition to that, we also make the use of the Gram iodine, which act as a model. So this crystal violet and the iodine, they will combine to form an insoluble dark purple compound, that is the crystal violet iodine complex, in the bacterial protoplasm and the cell wall. Now this compound is dissociable by using when we are giving the treatment of decolorizers. So these decolorizers, they dissolve the CVI complex and removes it from the cell. But the removal rate of this CVI complex is slower from the Gram positive bacteria as compared to Gram negative bacteria. So let's see how this happens. This is because of the difference between the cell wall composition of Gram positive and the Gram negative bacteria cell wall. The cell wall composition or the cell wall of Gram positive bacteria, they are thicker and the denser because of the higher percentage of peptidoglycan in their cell wall, and therefore this makes the cell wall of Gram positive bacteria to be less permeable to the strain as compared to the Gram negative bacteria, because they consist of lower percentage of peptidoglycan. In addition to that, Gram's iodine, it also play important role in enhancing the difference between the two types of bacteria. So let's see the procedure. First step is to take a grease free slide, then make a smear of the microorganism or the bacteria. Next step is air dry it. Next step, heat fix it, that is pass it over the Bunsen burner for 3 to 4 times. Now apply or flood your smear with the primary stain, that is the crystal violet. React, allow it to react for 5 minutes. Then add Gram's iodine, allow it to react for 2 to 3 minutes. Then give the treatment of decolorizer, wash your slide with the alcohol. Then it's when the purple color is stopped coming out from that bacterial cell, then give the treatment of the water, wash the slide with the water and apply secondary or the counter stain safranin and allow it to react for 5 minutes. Wash the slide with the tap water, air dry it and observe it under the oil immersion objective. Now when we observe under the oil immersion objective, you can easily differentiate between the Gram positive and the Gram negative bacteria. As Gram positive bacteria, they retain the violet color and they appear violet in color under the microscopic field, while Gram negative bacteria, they take up the counter stain and appear pink in color. Now next type of the differential staining is the acid fast staining. This is also known as the Zill-Nielsen staining. Now this method is the modification of Ehrlich method, which was used for the differentiation of acid fast and the non-acid fast bacteria. So in this case also, we are making the use of two stains, carbolfuxin and the methylene blue. So let's see the principle. Just like in case of the Gram positive bacteria, the difference is based on the cell wall composition of these two bacteria. Similarly, in acid fast bacteria, how we can differentiate between the acid fast and the non-acid fast bacteria. So the differentiation is between the presence of mycolic acid in their cell wall. So mycolic acid is a group of branch chain hydroxy lipids. Acid fast bacteria, they will retain the primary stain, that is the carboxylin, and therefore they appear red in color, while non-acid fast bacteria, because of the absence of mycolic acid within their cell wall, they will easily decolorize on washing with the acid and they take up the counter stain, that is the methylene blue. Now acid fast staining is most commonly used to identify Mycobacterium tuberculosis and the leprae. These are the pathogens that are responsible for the which causes the tuberculosis and leprosy. Now this bacteria within their cell wall, they are containing higher percentage of lipid, which is mainly constructed from the mycolic acids. So here you can see the cell wall of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and you can see large number of mycolic acid layers or mycomembranes will be present within the cell membrane. So what is the procedure of acid fast staining? Take a clean, sterile, glass-free slide, then make a thin uniform smear of the bacteria by using the inoculation loop. Allow the smear to dry and heat fix it. The smear was then flooded with the primary stain carboxylin and heat it until the steam arises. Preparation was allowed to stay for 5 to 7 minutes. The stain must not be allowed to evaporate or dry in the slide. Pour more carboxylin if necessary. Next step, then wash the slide under low stream of running water. Decolorize the smear with 20% sulfuric acid. Wash the slide again under running tap water and flood the smear with a counter stain with methylene blue for 2 minutes. Wash under running tap water. Slide was blood dried and examined under the microscope. Now this is the procedure or the flowchart of acid fast staining. First is the application of primary stain, that is the carboxylin. Then application of heat, which act as a mordant, so it penetrates the carboxylin within the cell wall. Then application of acid alcohol, which act as a decolorizer. And last one is the application of counter stain, that is the methylene blue. Now this is the observation that was we observe under the microscopic field. If you see red color bacteria, then you can say they are acid fast as they consist of mycolic acid within their cell wall. Now next type of the differential staining is the spore staining. So the bacterial endospore can be easily observed. The morphology of them can be easily observed in unstained wet films under the phase contrast microscopy. If the spore bearing organism, they are stained with the ordinary dyes or by using the Gram stain, the body of the bacillus is deeply colored and the spores is unstained and appear as clear area in the microscope. So it is possible we can employ the different staining procedure to introduce the dye into the substance of the spore. So when does the spore will retain the dye after treatment with decolorizing agent, and in this respect they behave like that of the acid fast bacteria. So let's see the principle of spore staining. So spores are nothing but the thick wall structure and they are highly resistant to the physical and chemical agent. They also have a capacity to survive for long periods even in unfavorable environmental conditions. So the resistance, high resistance or the heat resistance of the spore is due to the presence of high content or the high percentage of calcium dipicolinic acid within them. So in this case we are making the use of two dyes or the stains. Primary stain is the malachite green, is applied over the smear and steam it, steam the smear so that to enhance the penetration of biomalachite green within the spore coat. So once stained, the endospore does not readily decolorize even with the application of decolorizers, and the cytoplasm will take the counter stain, that is the safranin, and cytoplasm will appear red in color. So in this case also we are making the use of 0.25% of sulfuric acid. So procedure, first prepare a thin film of or smear of the microorganism and fix it with the minimal flaming. Next step, place the slide over a beaker of boiling water, rest it on the rim with the bacterial film uppermost. Next step, when within several seconds large droplets have condensed on the underside of the slide, flood it with a 5% of aqueous solution of malachite green and leave it to act for 1 minute while the water continues to boil. Third step, wash the slide in the cold water. Next step, heat with 0.5% safranin or 0.05% of basic fixing can also be used and allow it to react for 30 seconds. Next step, wash and dry. So this method color the spore green and vegetative bacterial cell appear red in colors. So this is the observation under oil immersion objective. You can see green color spores while pink color vegetative cells. Now next type of this differential staining is the capsule staining. Capsule, some bacteria, they secrete a gummy material on their surface which is usually made up of the polysaccharide and they make up the capsule. Now capsule is not essential for the life of bacteria but it may serve as a reserve food and it will provide protection to the bacterial cell against dehydration and also against phagocytosis. The chemical composition of capsule, it varies according to microorganism but it usually consists of polysaccharides, examples glucose, galactose, amino sugars, etc. Now these capsules, they are colorless and they have low refractive index and therefore they are difficult to observe without a special staining techniques. In addition to that, they are non-toxic and therefore they cannot be stained in the usual manner. We can also make the use of negative staining to demonstrate the capsule. So what is the principle of capsule staining? In case of the capsule staining, we are making the use of the Congo red, which is also an acidic stain and is used in the negative staining technique. It stains the background, leaving the capsule unstained. Then we are making the use of acid fuchsin, which fixes Congo red and react it with the blue background. So acid fuchsin, it stains the back organism pink, leaving the capsule colorless and the background will appear blue in color. So let's see the procedure. Place a drop of manival solution on a clear glass slide. By using the sterilized nichrome loop, cool it and just touch to the growth of microorganism on the slide. Mix the culture on the loop with a drop of manival solution on the slide. Next step, the drop was spread into a thin film. Next step, the film was allowed to dry completely. Next step, the smear was covered with manival solution too and allow it to react for 1 minute. Next step, the excess stain was discarded and dried in air. Observe under oil immersion objective. So here you can see the such a kind of the cells you can observe under the oil immersion objective. Now the next type of the differential staining is the flagellar staining. So flagellar staining, it provides the taxonomically valuable information about the presence or the distribution pattern of flagella on the prokaryotic cell. Bacterial and archaeal flagella are fine. They are thread-like organelles which are mainly used for the locomotion and they can be seen directly by using the electron microscopy. They are about 10 to 30 nanometer in diameter. To observe bacterial flagella with a light microscope, their thickness we have to increase by coating them with a mordant like the tannic acid and potassium or alum and then staining with the para-arsenide basic fuchsin. Now this is the flagella which act as a locomotory organ. So what is the procedure? grow bacteria for 16 to 24 hours on a non-inhibitory medium. For example, you can make the use of triptic soya agar or the blood agar. Touch a loofful of water onto the edge of the colony and let motile bacteria swim into it. Next step, then transfer the loofful into a loofful of water on a slide to get a turbid suspension and cover it with a cover slip. The bacterial suspension is prepared with the minimum of agitation so to minimizes the chances of detachment of the flagella. Next step, after 5 to 10 minutes, when many bacteria have attached to the surface of the slide and cover slip, apply few drops of reuse stains to the edge of the cover slip and leave the stain to diffuse into the film. The next step is examine with the microscope after standing 5 to 15 minutes at ambient temperature. So under oil immersion objective, you can see such a kind of the thread like projection which are coming out from the bacterial cell, and they are nothing but the flagella. Thank you.